WXW fans. Remember what I promised you last week? Well, here it is at last. Tonight, we are showing you the entire Money in the Box ladder match between three of WXW's top superstars. Tonight, you'll see which one of these competitors will be facing Sean Maluta for the WXW heavyweight title less than 2 weeks from now. I'm not going to waste any more of your time. Let's get right into the match. But I have to warn you, this one scared me half to death. I have never in my life been that nervous watching a live match. It's a scary one. Whew. And I'll be back afterward to tell you about the 4-year anniversary of WXW, Saturday, September 1st. Enjoy the match, but I warn you, it's a crazy one.
Sean, where are you going?
What do you mean, where am I going? It's a Money in the Box. The winner faces me at the 4th anniversary on September 1st. Where do you think I'm going? I'm getting a bird's eye view. I'm going out there.
WXW fans, we are back here with a big-time main event matchup for you. First time in WXW history, a triple threat Money in the Box ladder match. Now, folks, up there is the prize. Inside that briefcase is a contract for a future WXW World Heavyweight Championship matchup. And, folks, we also have the privilege to be joined by WXW Heavyweight Champion himself, Sean Maluta. How you doing today, Sean?
Who cares about Sean Maluta? Let's just go ahead and focus on these three combatants in this matchup. That's the most important part.
Wait a minute. Wallison, you actually mean to tell me you still have a job here?
Hey,
why don't you not worry about me?
What you need to worry about is those three guys in the ring gunning for your title.
I'll tell you what, you're exactly right. You know what? no disrespect to you guys, but this commentator's table ain't doing it for me. I'm getting a closer look. I'll see you guys later.
Yeah, he needs to go out there and get a bird's eye view. He needs to get that firsthand attention, because he's such an attention seeker, the WXW champion, Sean Maluda.
Well, that was a short stint here by Sean, but nonetheless, he makes his way to ringside to get a closer look at all the action. Keep in mind, folks, the winner of this matchup is in line to face Sean next month, September 1st, at our WXW. Oh, what a move!
Did you see that? Introducing him to the ladder early on. That is so smart.
Sean's
going to be feeling it later, let me tell you.
As I was saying, next month, our WXW four-year anniversary show, the winner of this contest will take on the champion, Sean Maluda.
You know, I can't wait for that show, let me tell you. I mean, the fourth, oh my Lord! He just dropped that ladder all over Brian Maddox. Wait, Nero's got control now.
All three men on the outside. Keep in mind, Sugar's no stranger to this contest. One of the longest tenured superstar in WXW has been in ladder matches before, has been in every type of a match, every type of a fight. He is no stranger to this. He's a former champion, and he wants to get back on top of the mountain. It's been too long, and Sugar is determined.
Sugar's got that ladder. He's trying to get it in the ring, get a position. Nero, on the other hand, stops him short. Oh, it catches him with a right and another one. Oh, right there, introduces the ladder right to the sternum. Oh, you know that's gotta hurt.
Keep in mind, folks, this is one of the most dangerous matches in our industry. Yeah, that ladder's there, but these guys are using it as a weapon to incapacitate their opponent so they can then climb the ladder and retrieve the prize.
And that prize is something else, folks. Let me tell you, it is a shot at Sean Maluda's WXW World Heavyweight Championship. And all three of these contenders, they want what's rightfully theirs in their eyes, which is to be on top of the mountain again.
All three of these guys, former WXW heavyweight champion. Keep in mind, Nick Nero, he's done it all here. He's the first ever Grand Slam champion, the first ever winner of the Extreme War, and he's looking to add the first ever Money in the Box win to his resume.
You know, if I remember correctly, Nero's reign was kind of cut short. He didn't really get a chance to really optimize his full potential when he was the WXW. Oh my God! Oh man, he just paid for it! Oh my God! Oh, and another one! I think Nero's dead over there.
The ladder hanging on the top rope in a very awkward position. Nero took quite a fall. And now Sugar seems to be in control. He looks up at the box.
Oh, Nero's moving, thank God. You know, not for nothing, but I think this actually favors Brian Maddox more than anybody else because of his just mean streak that he has. And plus that he's got Rico Moon on the outside to cause any interference that he's looking for.
Good point, Brian. Do not forget Rico Moon is the factor. Oh!
Oh my God!
Did you
Nero
see that?
Nero is done! Nero is done!
Nero's face met the steel ladder.
It's got to be shattered. It's got to be shattered, Mike. Oh my gosh. That man's going to have plastic surgery after this matchup. And you know what? There are no winners in this matchup because all of them are going to suffer the pain from this matchup.
But the pain is worth it for the richest, a shot at the richest prize in our industry. And Sugar ascends the ladder, the first one in this matchup to try to climb the ladder. Maddox cuts him off.
Oh, Nero is still messed up on the side. He's trying to gain his composure. Brian Maddox and Sugar. Let me tell you, these two men don't like each other at all.
Big time strength and power by Brian Maddox with a sidewalk slam. Sugar's down, and now Nero climbs the ladder.
Introducing his forearm to Nero's face. Brian Maddox asserting himself with young Nero. Oh, did you see that boot to the skull?
Rico Moon on the outside encouraging Brian to climb up and try to grab the box.
I mean, wouldn't you cheer on your prodigal son also?
Maddox now looking to center the ladder.
Maddox is roughly 300 pounds of just pure brawn. Oh, wait a second. What's Sugar doing? Oh, Sugar. How is he lifting him?
If anything, he's assisting Brian. Brian's on Sugar's shoulders.
Oh, no, this is the I don't like this. This is just... This is
both. Oh, my God! Oh, my goodness! Did you hear that? Unbelievable! Both big men on the top of the ladder come crashing down.
Wait, that opens up the door for Nero. Now he's going to just sneak right in and grab what's rightfully his, a shot of competing for the WXW World Heavyweight Championship and going on and carrying on that feud. Nero just caught short.
Nero almost to the tops. Almost to the top of the ladder, but Sugar knocks Nero back down.
You know what? All three men are down. I mean, hell, Rico should just get in the moon and try and grab the contract in.
Well, Rico's not a legal man. The three men are. Here comes Sugar looking to get back to a vertical base. Don't forget, folks, the champion, Sean Maluta, at ringside with a bird's eye view. He's got the best seat in the house. He wants to watch film, if you will. He's scouting his future opponent for next month, and you can't blame the champion.
He just interjected the ladder into the no-no zone. Brian Maddox is going to be a falsetto now.
There's that low area you spoke of earlier.
The low, low, low area.
What's this?
Oh!
Unbelievable! Big-time baseball slide, and Nero takes the ladder right to the midsection. He's on the outside in a great deal of pain.
This action is just unreal. What we've witnessed so far is history in the making in the first ever Money in the Box matchup here in WXW. And let me tell you something, this should be an annual tradition after what these three have gone through so far.
Oh, now Sugar just nailing Maddox with the ladder. Both these men in a great deal of pain. All three of these men sacrificing their bodies, doing all it takes for the Bucks.
Everything on the line. All their careers are at stake, basically, because they have... That was unreal. No, what is he doing? They have to win this match in order to get a shot at the World Heavyweight Champion, so really, everything is on the line for all three individuals tonight.
The ladder is down. Maddox is down. Boy, Maddox is really taking a beating over there in that corner. He's got to be in a great deal of pain.
I don't know. I think he loves pain, though. I mean, you can see it. He lives for it. He thrives for it.
He doesn't look like he loves it right now. Even Rico's pacing about.
Rico's pacing around like he's a parent that his child hasn't come home late night. You know, he's worried. Look at him. Nero's got the ladder set up. It's on top of Sugar. I mean, Sugar's got the whole ladder right there, right next to him. What's going to happen?
Nero now makes his way to the top.
Oh, this is Nero's night. No! Nero stops it. No way. Nero stops it.
Nice athleticism.
Oh!
Did you see that? Nero at the top of the ladder comes crashing down to the outside. Boy, he must have fell 15 feet.
Nero's life almost got ended. What a heck of a bump that Nero just took. I mean, from the top of the ladder to the outside, like you were saying, Nunes. I mean, it's got to be 15 feet in the air, and I'm sorry, but... How people say that we
look
changed
at this. Look
no
at
way.
This. Look at this. Sugar now. Oh!
Introduced right into the steel post.
Rico Moon with the distraction. Got Sugar off his game, and Sugar paid for it. Face full of ring post. Good job. Smart move by Nick Nero.
Hey, his aptitude, like I said before, is one of his biggest assets in his arsenal.
Say that three times fast.
His biggest asset in his arsenal. Biggest asset in his arsenal. Biggest asset in his arsenal.
Okay, I didn't mean literally. But nonetheless, back to the action now. Maddox finds his way back to the inside. Nero setting up the ladder, but it's nowhere near the middle of the ring.
Rico is beside himself, doesn't even know what to think. And Nero going for the big maneuver and hits it.
But keep in mind,
there is no pinfalls in this.
Good point, Brian. I was just going to say, there is no pinfalls in this contest. The only way to win is to climb the ladder and retrieve the box.
I guess that wasn't that easy for you to say that time. But as we look, Nero is on top. What has he got in store? I do not know. Look at Sugar, stops him.
Nero now in an awkward position. Sugar, both men now on top of the ladder. Oh,
headbutt.
Both men up high. Something's got to give.
I don't like where this is going. Both men up top. Is he going for a suplex?
Oh, my God.
No way. He'll shatter him. Tower of Doom. No. 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 Oh, my God.
Did you see that? Unbelievable. Nick Nero once again falls 15 feet from the top of the ladder, crashing down. Tremendous superplex by Sugar.
That was a Tower of Doom with a superplex and almost a power bomb variation from Maddox. Let me tell you, both men are split in half. Maddox actually being able to get on top. Now Maluda's fighting with Rico on the outside.
Maluda and Rico on the outside.
Maddox needs to stop concentrating on Rico and go for his shot so he can get back what's rightfully his.
You know, you gotta respect all three of these tremendous athletes giving it their all, putting their bodies on the line. This is truly something else. What a historic night. What a historic match. The first ever triple threat Money in the Box ladder match.
For the first time ever, I've never seen a matchup like this ever in my life, Nunez. Oh, I'm so fortunate today. I get the best seat in the house. I don't care what Maluda says. This is the best seat in the house. Where the seat is where the fans are watching from. All this great WXW action, you can only catch that here live in Mineola, Florida.
Maddox now climbing the ladder. Sugar right on his tail.
Who's gonna get the contract? Both men are on top.
Both men gotta be careful.
Big stiff shot from Sugar. Oh, and Brian Maddox answers back. Both men wobbling. Oh, back and forth.
I'd like to see Sugar try to superplex Brian. Both men now on top. Oh, what's this? He blocks it.
Oh, and introduces the head, and Maddox falls down.
Sugar's just a few steps away. Come on, Sugar. Come on, Sugar.
Oh, you just missed it. Nero just slapped Maluda. They were having a verbal exchange on the outside. Now Maluda's involved. Oh, my God. Sugar has won. Wait a second. I don't think the referee sees it.
Sugar has retrieved the box.
Oh! No!
What's this?
It is Nick Nero! Nick Nero!
Nick Nero stole it! Nick Nero stole it! I cannot believe it! Unbelievable! Referee tied up with the champion, Sean Maluda, on the outside. Referee had his back turned. Sugar retrieved the box, but Nero stopped him and took it from him behind the referee's back.
No, he didn't take anything. He saw his opportunity and he took it, okay? You know how many people have been walking all over Nero as of late? Well, you know what? Now it's time for Nero to get what's rightfully his and to get a shot at Sean Maluda's WXW World Heavyweight Championship. And let me tell you something, he rightfully earned it. I don't care what you say, Nunez.
This match was something else, folks.
History
what a treat. What a treat to call this action. I have never witnessed an exciting matchup like this one. Sugar retrieved the box with the ref's back turned. Nero then seized his opportunity to steal the box and possibly steal the championship from Sean Maluda. We'll have to wait and see next time, September 1st. Nick Nero is our new number one contender for Sean Maluta's WXW World Heavyweight Championship.
You know, Nero and Maluta have had the feud of the year last year, and you know what? I can't wait to see the second part of this feud, but let me tell you something. The planes are leveled now. Nick Nero has done it all here, and he wants to recapture what's his, the WXW World Heavyweight title, and he's going to do it, Nunes. Mark my words, because he's your hero, Nick Nero.
Guys, what happened?
Not now.
What happened? What happened? What happened is that Sugar ruined my chance at my heavyweight title. It's mine. It doesn't belong to Sean Maluta. It doesn't belong to Nick Nero. And it sure as hell doesn't belong to Sugar. He ruined it again.
Next time, we're going to take him. We're going to crumble him. We're going to break every bone in his body. And you know why? You know why?
Because I can.
You're a dead man. Get out of here.
Sugar, what happened out there?
What happened was I was the number one contender. I should have been the number one contender. I was the one that pulled that briefcase down. Next thing you know, I'm seeing white, and they're raising Nick Nero's hand.
There's a lot of history between you guys. What's the next step?
Nick Nero's a punk. He doesn't deserve a shot. He doesn't even deserve to be in this business. I can beat Nick Nero on my worst day and his best. But you know what? I'm gonna let him have his due for now. Sooner or later, he can get his little match with Sean for the championship. But I'm still lurking. I wasn't the former WXW heavyweight champion for the longest time for nothing. So Nero, Maluta, that was the last of me. And Nero, that you can believe.
I watched that match live. I watched it afterward, and I watched it now. And all three times, I had to cringe and look away. What a match that was. And it was clear as day that Suga had that match won. He had the briefcase. But that slimeball Nick Nero took advantage of the fact that the referee was distracted on the outside, stole the briefcase from Suga, and took the official win for himself. So now, Nick Nero has to face Sean Maluta less than 2 weeks from now at the 4-year anniversary show of WXW in Florida for the heavyweight title. Crazy, right? But that's not all. The three-way tag team title match, tag team title rematch, and there must be a winner. I've also received word that Su Young, the Japanese superstar, was not happy with the way Kimberly stole a win from her. So that match is coming back. Su Young versus Kimberly for the women's title. And I don't want to give anything away, but CJ O'Doyle, the Irish Lionheart, will be facing Sweet Johnny Velvet. Oh, and how about this? Suga now wants a piece of former heavyweight champion Brian Maddox for getting screwed in that ladder match you just saw. I'm telling you, you have got to come out and see these matches live and in person. I promise you, you will have a fantastic time, and you will never, ever, ever want to miss another live WXW wrestling event. Check out our website at WXWWrestling.com for all kinds of news and updates and merchandise. Lots of merchandise. Until next week, everybody, I'm Vale anoa'i. See you next time right here on WXW Rage TV.